is the book of Hebrews 6 and 17. Get right to the point wherein the Heavenly Father, or God, which his name is Yahweh, his son's name is Yahweh Shai, wherein God willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise. Who's that? That's the nation of Israel, beginning with the elect. The heirs of promise. Heir means someone who's set to inherit something. The first thing we're going to inherit, those of us that are part of the elect, is salvation by Yahweh Shai into those chariots. Then we're going to inherit those new bodies that the Apostle Paul talked about. As a matter of fact, the Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 15, we shall be changed in the twinkling of an eye. Like that, we're going to get these new indestructible bodies. In other words, we're never going to die. Death is going to be a thing of the past. So we're going to be like gods. Psalms 82 and 6. You know, we're going to have godlike powers in the flesh. We're going to have godlike powers in the flesh. I just gave you a couple of examples of what we're set to inherit. That's why it says ears of promise.
All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Kakwadash. Double honors unto the apostles and the elders of GMS, who rule well, teach well, being great examples to his younger brothers. And peace and blessings, salutations, hopeful lake out there, pushing his word and truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. Pushing to get up out of here, Shalom, to hopefully the believers, the listeners, whom have came back to the obedience of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. All right, and today, all right, this morning, what I want to get into is this Hebrew word for conquer, which is Manatazak. Okay, Manatazak, which means conqueror. All right, in the Hebrew. Okay, and when you go through the scriptures, you know, it tells us that what we have a victory. Okay, or we're going to conquer, all right, in righteousness, man. Okay, led by Yahweh Shai. Okay, so this Hebrew word, conqueror, in Hebrew is Manatazak. All right, Manatazak. All right, so let's get some scriptures, okay, to give life, you know, to this word. Now, when you go to the book of Revelation, it's beginning with Yahweh Shai. Okay, now this is Revelation 6 and 2, and it says, and I saw, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering to conquer. And this is Yahweh Shai. Okay, and he's going to come and conquer the earth in righteousness and establish the throne of David eternally in righteousness in the earth. Now, and the white horse is the chariot, okay? And Yahweh Shai is going to be on in his return, all right? And he's going to conquer on their chariot, okay, through war. Their bow represents war, okay? And the crown represents what? He's going to overcome, okay? And have the victory and the dominion, you see? Now, you get the word conquer, all right? And you can see this thing. Greek word Nikao, okay, where you get Nike, okay, and it says to conquer, to carry off the victory, to come out victorious of Hamashiach, victorious over all his foes, okay. One, it says, when one is arranged or goes to law to win the case, to maintain one's cause, and we have the victory even over, okay, the accusations of Esau, Edom, you know, because he's trying to present us as if we're off. That's why he's trying to flip the narrative. But we have the victory over this man in every way, you know. That's why scripture gives us the instructions on how to be, to remain blameless, so we can have the victory. Okay, we're gonna have victory over his accusations, the accuser of the brethren, okay, and we're gonna have a victory, all right, in the physical over this man's military, okay, over his enchantments, okay, the victory over the beast. You see, so you go from there. Let's get this All right? Because we have the victory through Yahweh Shai. Okay? We have to overcome the flesh, overcome this society, not be weak to this society. Okay? That's our battle right now. And Yahweh Shai is going to come conquer, all right, in the physical. You see? But Yahweh Shai is within us, and he already conquered, all right, in the spirit, this society. Okay? And his spirit within us is pushing us to conquer as well. St. John 16 and 33 said, "These things have I spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world." Okay? So when you go to overcome, okay, in the Greek, what do you see? The same word, nakeo. Okay? So we're going to conquer the flesh. We're going to conquer, all right, bending the knee to Baal, man, and having faith and waiting on Yahweh Shai to come conquer, okay, in the physical. You see, because Yahweh Shai is in us, man. Okay? And let's get that. 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. All right, 1:4:4. It says, "Ye are of the Most High, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world." Okay? So you get this same word, overcome, here, and what do you have? Nakeo, the same word, that victory. Okay? Because why? Greater is he, okay, that is in you than he that is in the world. So Yahweh Shai is within us and pushing us to this victory to overcome as he did. He has already overcame. He's at the right hand glorified in the spirit. Okay, we have to overcome. We're overcoming. Okay, getting the victory and conquering things, man. That's why we have to conquer things in our day-to-day, in our personal life, man. You know, and it's leading to the great victory that Yahweh Shai is coming with, man. You see? So let's go from there. Let's get the book of Romans 8. Romans 8 and 37. It says, "Nay, in all things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us." It said we are more than conquerors. Now, let's get this definition. Okay, let's see what this goes into. Okay, it says more than conquerors. Okay, more than conquerors. Look at this word.
Strong's G5245. Hypernikao. Hypernikao.
It says hyper nikao. Okay, hyper nikao. It means to be more than a conqueror, to gain a surpassing victory, man. Okay, hey, we're being built to dominate, to conquer first ourselves, our situations, and then eventually we're going to overcome what Esau Edom is coming with. We're trying to make the world bend the knee, the outward temptation. That's something we have to conquer, okay, to be found worthy. You see, but the scriptures say we're going to have the surpassing victory. He made us more than conquerors, man. Which means, hey, we're going to blow this thing out, man. Okay? It's going to be, okay? When you go to the scrolls, it says to vanquish beyond, to gain the decisive victory more than a conqueror, man. And that's through Yahweh Shai that's within us, man. We have more than enough than what we need to conquer, all right? The circumstances that we're in and the circumstances that we're going to be in, man. You know, so that's the point. I just want to bring that out real quick, going into that Hebrew word, all right, for conqueror. So let's look at it again, all right, conqueror, all right, in the Hebrew, natazak, all right, natazak, all right. So Lord will, you will edify until next time. I say shalom, form yasha'ala, baba, ba, DTA soon, shalom.